worrying about no farmers, we ain't stating that. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
To get anything out of that run.
On second and 9, Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. He's going deep for Brown. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they run successful.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. On the return, Harris. Officially, that will go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Saints will take over with a 1st down and 10. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. 3 tight ends are out there. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. A solid run on 1st down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3.
Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. Open man is the tight end, Troutman. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 6 yards, the pickup, and that's a 1st down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Breeze now on 1st down. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 12 yards there, good for a Saints 1st down. Now Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. The ball comes out. Tipped us off. They wanted to play ultra-aggressive, forcing fumbles. They just did that right there.
They took it to the next level, didn't they? You're exactly right, because everyone talks about being aggressive on defense and tackling well, but they were talking about getting after the football, making sure the ball was stripped out each and every time they lined up someone to get them on the ground.
And the adjustment working early. Able to get 7 on that 1st down pass play. 2nd and 3. Take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. That one, a 1st down pickup of 8. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only the control and things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the 2nd and the 3rd levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. And he's taken down inside the 30. 11 yards there, first down.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Brady's throw complete there to Evans. Goes into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Mike Evans, 29 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC?
Run after catch. And he loves that, and he's going to carry that in at contract time.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? They'll come up now second and four from the 31. He hits the slant route to Thomas. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Good for us.
7 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
Play action, Breeze, rolling to his left, and it's hauled in by Jared Cook. Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 23 yards on the play.
The 38-yard line.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 38. Shotgun now for Breeze. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
8 yards on the pickup.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. 23 yards, the final tally.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space, the big guys leading the way.
Down, but it winds up incomplete.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Drew Brees on target to Emmanuel Sanders. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And three at the 30-yard line.
A good run got seven on first. Here's second and three. Back to the ground, this time to Jones. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They begin on the ground with Kamara. Upended after a gain of five, up to the 25-yard line. Here's a second and five now from the 25. Now a play fake. Breeze. He sets to fire deep. This is taken in. It's complete.
I think it's pretty safe to say that initially they had to be thinking about trying to get into field goal range. But after that shot right there, they've got to be thinking bigger right now.
And that was probably their thought offensively. If we hit this, great, let's go for the end zone. If not, settle for a field goal. Looks like they can try to hit pay dirt. On play action, it's Breeze. Two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way. Oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover him. That type of indecision can open up to even more big plays.
From the gun, it's Breeze. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. It was the linebacker, Devin White, there to knock it away.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Another shot from the nine on second and goal. They fake the give. Here's Breeze. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Third and goal, and still a long way from the end zone. Now Breeze. Set to begin their next possession. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it? And he's taken down here by the Saints. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. The final shot before half for Brady. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. He will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number three. Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said is they went back out there.
Double team, it's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it, and they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
13 yards.
Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. Now a first down carry by Jones. Able to push forward for about four down to the 37.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Oh, look at that, a diving catch.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
He'll set up the screen to Fournette. A completion, yes, but certainly not what they wanted. A loss of a full 6 yards. Well, if you're going to turn things around in a game like this, Charles, those are the kind of plays that you need.
And I just love the way that defense rallied to the football on that one. They got the completion, but he was smothered behind the line of scrimmage. And when you make
the ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And it's a good return here as he'll get all the way up close to the 35. I know it appeared he was saying, hey, give me the football, I'm open, but I don't know if that's a pass that he should have thrown there.
Well, I don't think we've ever met a wide receiver that doesn't think he is open or is about to be open.
True.
So when you throw your hand up in the air and tell your quarterback, hey, I'm available, he's trusting that you are. In this case, he was not, and it turned into disaster for them.
More muscle up front for this second and two. They've got three tight ends out there. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
Breeze looking to throw on third and two. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Now left side on the swing pass. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
Well, open man is Michael Thomas. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 17 there and a New Orleans first down.
10 at the 26-yard line.
Working from the gun, it's Breeze. That's going to be caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Another Saints first down.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Back now here live in New Orleans. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Again, it's Breeze. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. That's Alvin Kamara with a grab from Drew Breeze. And the Saints have taken the lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Again, they'll throw with Breeze. The quick slant caught. And he is not going to make it. So they won't be able to move this lead up to a touchdown as it'll remain a five-point ball game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys.
And this will be caught at the 30. And all the way down to the 26.
Complete. Two.
It's a big play there for the Buccaneers. 52 yards.
First down, Tampa Bay.
So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Looking for the end zone. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And it's second down.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. On the draw, this is Fournette. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Touchdown.
Leonard Fournette. 26 yards, and the Bucs are going to retake the lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Bradley Pinion to kick off.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. And he stopped immediately there. There to stop him was Carlton Davis.
Second and 10 at the 25.
Again, it's Kamara. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Brings up third down and 11.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Breeze now to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. He's got a man complete. And as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That could very well be a defining play in this game. A touchdown, that gives them the lead, and they took a major step towards getting there with that big play right there.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And he's got it. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Touchdown. Michael Thomas, 33 yards. And the Saints have retaken the lead. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller. They retain their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Well, they may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Brady now on first down. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he'll be out of bounds after his short pickup, as that's going to take us to the two-minute warning. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. Brady's throw there complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
Brady going to try and throw on third down. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play. This point in the game. The sack coming from defensive end Cameron Jordan. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with a minute 4 left to go in the game.
Well, this has been all that we'd hoped for. Two of the game's all-time great QBs slugging it out in a one-score game here in the second half. First and 10.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
He'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
He's got his big tight end, Gronkowski. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have two timeouts left, so they can stop the clock twice. This one's not quite over yet.
No, and what you're doing on defense, you're going to use both timeouts, obviously. But you've got to call defense is going to force the issue early, meaning you want that play over fast. You don't want to give them time to dance around in the the backfield or run a wide sweep that'll take a long time, blitz them, put pressure on them, make sure that play ends quickly so that you can go ahead and keep moving.
So second and nine, and you have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here.
To throw is Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. Oh, what a juke into space. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. So first and 10 now from the 30. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze rolling to his right. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. A big game there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column.
First down. First and goal at the 2-yard line. Today's final.